Well, the morning commute in Warren County has a new addition to it tonight. Officials cut the ribbon on the new northbound portion of the Jeremiah Morrow Bridge.
WLWT News 5's Christy Davis went out to Ohio's tallest bridge to bring us in on the action.
Two, three.
3 years since turning to dirt and 49 years to the day since the completion of the first Jeremiah Morrow Bridge, officials cut the ribbon on the new northbound side of the 2,300-foot expanse.
And is designed for at least 75-year service life, hopefully closer to 100. And this bridge is designed to carry superloads, where the existing bridges on either side of you were not designed to be able to carry those heavy loads.
Just like on that day in 64, the Lebanon High School band played. And just like that day, the bridge is being touted as a sign of things to come.
If we don't have this piece in place, none of the other projects matter because you can't get to them.
Those projects span the 71 corridor and include improvements at Fields Ertl and a proposed interchange at MLK and the Brent Spence Bridge. OKI Executive Director Mark Polosinski says the Jeremiah Morrow construction project provides a valuable lesson for the folks farther south.
Move quickly. Build it quickly. You know why? Because if you build it quicker, it's cheaper. It saves taxpayers money. It protects us. The safety improvements are immense. So, yeah, that's a great lesson for us to learn. We're gonna have a ribbon cutting on the Brent Spence Bridge a heck of a lot sooner than people think.
But first, it's time for the rubber to meet the road up north.
So, starting tomorrow morning, if you got to come this far north, you will be commuting across the new Jeremiah Morrow Bridge. From the bridge, Christy Davis, WLWT News 5.
The new southbound portion of the bridge is already under construction. The first demolition of the old Jeremiah Morrow Bridge will happen later this winter.